ready? Happy New Year! That's it? That's the New Year gift for our friends and clients? Well, this might be the first ever 360 degrees IP video. They can turn their device around and see us all. No, this is not enough. We must offer them an adventure into the IP world, and better one related to the end of year celebrations. Alright, but what will it be about? Let's tell about the Olivier salad, probably the world's first salad protected as an know-how. Its creator Lucien Olivier kept the recipe secret for a long time, till his assistant learned about it and left to work in another restaurant called Stilichny, which became another name for the salad. Olivier salad and the festive menu, it seems so outdated to me. Any more ideas? What about the Veuve Clicquot champagne? This lady is believed to be behind the very first international trademark protection agreement between Russia and France. Sounds great, but you see, our clients may be watching with their children, so no alcohol in our story, please. You said children, then let us offer them a true Christmas IP fairy tale. This story is closely related to Russia, and to St. Petersburg in particular, but it starts in Kaliningrad, where the author of the tale studied law and worked as a judge at a legal court. Have you guessed it? The Nutcracker. Exactly, The Nutcracker. Written by Ernst Theodor Amadeus Hoffmann, a Kaliningrad-born lawyer and judge, and a famous writer of suspense stories. Well, but what's the connection with IP in St. Petersburg? I once read a ruling by Hoffman and there was not a single word about copyright or trademarks. It's not about Hoffman, you see. Let us follow our colleagues Nikolai and Anastasia to the Court of Arbitration to learn the story. Action! Here we are in front of the Court of Arbitration of St. Petersburg and the Leningrad region that every lawyer here knows. But that's not our destination. Have a look at this old building, all covered in scaffolding. It was here that Alexandre Dumas, the author of The Three Musketeers, lived in the middle of the 19th century. He would come out to this very balcony or walk down these very steps here to look over the magnificent Neva River. Wait, Dumas? Wasn't it Hoffman? Good point. Well, Dumas was a bit of a lawyer too. Before becoming a renowned writer, he went to Paris to study law. Besides, he went down to history not only for his novels, but also as the first person to claim his right to self-image. At the time when photography was just a budding art, one photographer sold the images of Dumas and his loved one at bookshops and markets. Dumas brought the case before court and obtained the prohibition of such sales. This was the first precedent of self-image protection. Got it. Now why the Nutcracker? Alexandre Dumas reworked Hoffman's fairy tale. In fact, the Nutcracker story we all know is the one written by Dumas, not Hoffman. Dumas changed the emphasis to give the story a positive turn. Thanks to him, the Nutcracker is the story of overwhelming love that turns the wooden toy into a prince. The new interpretation appeared just 22 years after Hoffman's death, but as copyright expired shortly at those times, Hoffman's creation was already in the public domain, so by reworking it, Dumas did not commit any rights violation. Dumas' version was later turned into the world-famous ballet to the music of Peter Tchaikovsky. Now I see, thank you. Let us remember that Peter Tchaikovsky was a lawyer by profession and studied at the law school in St. Petersburg. Well, he was more into creation of intellectual property than protection. Right. And we're standing here in front of the former Grand Hotel. From here, in December 1892, Peter Tchaikovsky left to attend the first night of his new ballet, The Nutcracker, staged at the Mariinsky Theatre. And over here, there is another building where many years ago, Klein's partners first came together to work in IP. Yeah, so they tell. Well, do you know that Tchaikovsky did not write The Nutcracker alone? Really? Yes, he based his work on exact choreography by Marius Petipa, who had determined the musical rhythm and all the main episodes. Then had the IP story gone different way in the 19th century, Petipa could have claimed to be the co-author of Tchaikovsky's music. So this is the place? Around the world, the Ballet Nutcracker is known in the staging by George Balanchine, who was born in Saint-Petersburg in 1904 and after the revolution emigrated to the United States, where he promoted the Nutcracker as a Christmas fairy tale. And though Balanchine was not a lawyer, he was often on the jury. That's not the most interesting thing about him. In fact, Balanchine's staging of the Nutcracker provided an answer to one of the most important questions in the world of ballet. Which one? Whether dance movements are protected by copyright? I remember seeing a recent Fortnite case. Balanchine's copyright claim actually came up earlier. In 1986, the New York Court of Appeals ruled that even separate movements and parts of the dancers in the Nutcracker are protected by copyright and cannot be used without the author's consent. Wow. So many things brought together. Lawyers, Hoffman, Winter, Peter Tchaikovsky, Balanchine as a juror, one lawyer reworking the creation of another lawyer, and finally the IP breakthrough, the first instance of copyright protection of dance movements. By the way, the Nutcracker music dating back to the beginning of the 20th century can be used freely. You can listen to it for the entire New Year night. That's a cool story. So let us wish our clients, friends and colleagues more amusing stories in 2021. May your life be full of miracles and let the good always beat the evil. Let magic happen every single moment for every one of us. Happy New Year!